Recently, I've shown you guys this video on how to make a vertical garden in Lumion. I noticed that many people got interested in this topic, so I decided to make the same topic with D5 render and using only assets from the D5 render library. Hey, what's up guys? My name is Nuno Silva and on this channel I share architectural visualization tips and tutorials. Stick around because I will announce the D5 render challenge 2, in which I will be part of the jury. But I'll give you all the details later in this video and I'll leave the links in the description below so you can read more about it. So without further ado, let's get started. So here I have my model and the first thing I want to show you is how the model looks. It's a very basic. I just made this section here and I even added a little bit like this, so if I wanted I could put here some lighting to light up the vertical garden. But it's a very simple model, just like this. And all of this is assets from the D5 render library. Some of them are from the pro version, but they do have assets for the free version that you can use as well. So let me go here. So the first thing to make the vertical garden, and again, this is using only assets from D5 render, okay, so their own library. We'll go here to assets and can maybe put it this here. Just let me make it a little bit smaller. So we have here the material. When you go to this online, you have material, model and particle. So I'm selecting here the material and I'll go here to outdoor ground. And here on this category, you'll find many assets for grass. So we can select something that looks more or less covered. It can be this one, grassland 01. And now I'm just going to close this. If we press I on the keyboard, we can call the material picker. And I'm just going to select this material. And now we can see here the properties on the right side. And on this right side, you can see that it has this displacement. I don't need this displacement here, so I'm just going to make it custom. And now I can make it triplanar because I have actually not just this plane here. So I'm going to make it triplanar so I can make it easier this way. And maybe 0.5 or 0.3. Yeah, I think this is a good proportion for this grass material. And now we need to go again to the assets. And this time let's go to model. I already favored a couple of assets that we are going to use, but I'm going to show you where you can get this asset. You go to nature and on this nature, you'll find here the category called shrubs. And it might take some time to load up because since this is all online, it's loading the list from online. So if you have a slow internet connection, it might take some time and it might show here that there are no assets, but just give it a little bit of time and it will show up this list. Because as you can see here, I can select all of these assets, but if I don't have an asset, this is an example here, it will show up this icon that you can download the asset into your local library. And so here are assets that I think work great for this vertical garden. For example, this one, this Monstera. This one here, I think it would work great just for covering up a little bit of the wall. And then you have other assets. For example, this one, this cluster, it's nice. And they have several versions of the same Monstera, so you can mix and match. And of course, I encourage you to create your own version, even with maybe some more exotic plants, and just try and see what you'll get. But I have here the ones that I favorite. And so I can start with this one here. So this tree, it's nice for covering up a little bit. So I can just rotate it like this. And then I'll press V so I can call the scaling. And I'll scale it way, way low like this. And press V again. And so this one will be just to cover this area. And by the way, you can still, if you want to see this a little bit better, because I already have here all the settings for the final render, but you can press Alt 2, for example, if you want to see just a wireframe to be faster, or the clay model. Maybe we can work with this version a little bit and just place these assets for now. And so you can just duplicate this asset, rotate the same asset, maybe put it a little bit lower. Just pay attention so it doesn't pass so much on this wall here. You can also, just close this first, you can click here on this icon flip and it will flip the asset. Okay, and this way you are just creating, basically it's this with the same asset, creating several variations, so it doesn't look like it's all the same asset repeated over and over. You can as well make it, for example, the same asset, make it a little bit lower so it just sticks a little bit from this area. Okay, move it a little bit, then you can rotate. And so I'll just speed up a little bit because I'll cover all of this area and you can do the same in your project. Before we continue, and if you are enjoying the content so far and would like to create something great with D5, they are currently hosting the D5 Render Challenge 2. And the challenge is about how far would you go? This is related to, in the past years, we've been kept from traveling or having to keep social distance. So now, with D5, you can create a world of your own and travel with your imagination. They have thousands of dollars in prizes, and you can read all the rules and submission dates in the links that I'll provide in the description below. And everyone can participate in this. It's free to enter, and you just need to use D5 Render for this. So now that we finished this part, let's move it again to the lit mode by pressing Alt 1. And we can see that it's starting to look nice, this area. I'm just going to change here the exposure a little bit so we can see better. Okay. And of course, we're not going to leave it exactly like this. We should always mix and match more assets. So I have this one here. And on this one, I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So I'm going to just rotate. Oops, it's not this one. I'm going to rotate like this, 90 degrees. And then I'm going to just scale it down, maybe like this. And again, move it like this, a little bit lower. Just flip the asset so it doesn't look exactly the same. Again, just scale it down, move it forward. So this is a little bit of repetitive work, but I think the end result is quite nice. And should always try with different assets and see how they will look. You can try with these ones. You can see on my list the ones that I favorite and try to duplicate as well. And just a little bit more like this. By the way, when you see this, it means that you are going to just move it on this plane. Okay, so if I want to move it just on this plane, okay, you can use this this icon here. And I'm holding the shift to duplicate the item. Okay, something like this. Then I'm going into assets and we have this one. I like this one. So I'm going to select this one. Well, actually, I'm going to do one thing. Instead of just showing this, I'm just going to put all the assets here. And this one, probably. This one I don't need. And maybe this one. Yeah. Okay, so I have all my assets here. This one I can already make it smaller. Okay. So now I'm just going to make this asset here, rotate, and make it bigger, and move it forward. Well, actually, we need to place it here first. Yeah, so that is too big. Let's make it a little bit smaller and maybe rotate, something like this. Let's duplicate another version, flip it, maybe something like this to this side. I think here next to the to this armchair will be nice. Okay. Here you see that it's entering a little bit the wall, but it doesn't matter because we'll cover this with other assets, and even with the camera angle that you're going to take the render, it will not be visible, so it doesn't matter so much. So I'm gonna get this other asset. And this one I'm not going to rotate, I'm just gonna leave it like this. And maybe like this, duplicate, and I'm going to flip, move it up. Okay, one more here, maybe smaller, and can be a little bit like this inside. Okay, maybe one more, just flip. Little bit mixed with this other vegetation. Okay. And this one is nice. So rotate this one. Can be about here. And scale it. And just move it forward. Just some leaves will be sticking out like this. And maybe like this. Okay. Then another one. Duplicate. And something like this. Okay. Maybe one on top, but a little bit smaller. Oops, it's not this one. Okay. Just reduce the size and flip. Maybe rotate. And something here. Also here, maybe the plant will try to reach more the light, so. Okay. Okay. And now the final one. So we can, whoops, let's move it back. And rotate about here, move it up and like this. Maybe for this one you can rotate. Oh, I like it like this. Let's just move it up. Let's mix this together. And maybe some other instances of these ones, but a little bit smaller, and maybe one here, just a little bit like this, a little bit smaller. And another one. Can duplicate this one just one more time, and let's see our camera. Okay, and now you can see how does this look. I'm going to just again make this maybe a little bit brighter. Okay, and like this, very quickly we have a vertical garden, and using only assets from the D5 render library. And if you'd like to learn more about D5 Render, I do have a course for that. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to give me a like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.